Hello, my beautiful Pisces. Welcome to your horoscope forecast, and it's going to be for your mid-monthly. It's going to cover love, wealth, and what you need to know spiritually that you don't know they need to know that could help you with your situation. I want to thank you guys so much for liking, sharing, subscribing, and thank you to my members. I really appreciate all of your support. And if you guys would like a live person read with me, or you would like to learn about your life purpose using astrology, or you'd like to take my 6-week long tarot course, all the information is in the description box below, or you can find it on my website, jenniferwalkerzen.com. Okay, so let's talk about it. All right, so we're going to be looking at your love interest feelings, or excuse me, your love interest, your romantic love life, what's going to happen for the time period of now to the end of April, and career and finance now until the end of April, and what you need to know spiritually that you don't know they need to know that could help you. All right, my beautiful darlings, if you guys like it this way, you want me to continue this way, hit that like button. Let me know in the comments below. You can do both. Let's jump right in. So what's going to my Pisces romantic love life? Give me 9 cards for my Pisces romantic love life. Give me 9 cards for my Pisces career and finance for now until the end of April. Show me the cards I need to see. Show me the cards I need to see. All right, so let's take a look here. Oh, Pisces, look at this, out the gate. All right, so this is gonna be the first half, okay? So this is what's gonna happen soon here, okay? This is going to be what's gonna happen next. And this is going to be the end of the month here. This last 3 is the end of the month. Okay, so you guys are finally getting clarity, answers. Now, the clarity and the answers seem to be about somebody who was avoiding a situation or walking away from a relationship, okay? So it seems like you're going to get clarity about why they walked away or why they avoided this situation. Okay, so let me just get more information about this. It seems like you're like, you finally, I feel like you guys are like, why didn't I know this before? Why didn't I know this before? Okay, so what's gonna happen to my Pisces romantic love life? Give me 9 cards for my Pisces romantic love life. Give me 9 cards for my Pisces career and finance now until the end of April. Show me the cards I need to see. Show me the cards I need to see. So basically, it's just like, yes, okay, victory here, all right? So you were stuck, you were stagnant in a situation, stuck in the middle of a situation, and you finally get clarity, okay? So this person shares their thoughts about why they walked away, why they avoided this, why they weren't dealing with their emotions. And I see that they are single and available to pursue, okay? So someone is a single and available to pursue, or there were some kind of concerns about being used. Okay. All right, let's keep going here. Let's go to my Pisces romantic love life. Give me 9 cards to my Pisces romantic love life. Give me 9 cards to my Pisces career and finance. Now until the end of April. Show me cards you need to see. Show me cards you need to see. Okay, so you're going to get what you want here, okay? You're going to get what you want. As I said, there's a victory here because the Ace of Swords is what? Victory. Aha. Clarity around the stuck situation. And it's like, wow. This is what I want. What I feel like, what I see, what I feel is that this person possibly could have been in a relationship, okay? And they're walking away from a relationship to be with you. So what's gonna happen my Pisces romantic love life now until the end of April? Show me the cards you need to see. Show me the cards I need to see, okay. Yeah, then we're being honest. Okay, so it's dishonesty. You're gonna get clarity about that. Okay, seems like it's the next couple weeks for this. Okay, so you're about to be really happy, Sun card energy. You're about to be doubly happy, Sun card energies. Okay, so let's keep going. All right, so there is a relationship being offered here. This person said they've fallen in love with you, and it looks like when it came to this situation with other people, right? They weren't telling the truth, and you found out. There's a healing energy, and something's coming into balance. This person says they feel really bad, and they regret what happened. about this lying and deception. So they're trying to make it up to you. They're trying to fix it. Yep, they're feeling bad. They know they messed up. They made a mistake. They fumbled you, okay? It looks like some passionate exercises are gonna take place here with this Knight of Wands energy. Pleasure seeking going on, okay. Yeah, but you're trying to be wise about your decision making, not trying to make any rash decisions about it. And it's something about an offer or huge potential where you want, money and finance not to play a factor in this. Or for some of you guys, this is like the Ace of Pentacles for my deck. So I feel like a lot of you guys are like, I don't want to rush into anything with this person. I don't want this player kind of energy. I just want to move away from like just doing something passionate with this person and making it a little bit more serious. Mm-hmm. Yep, we got marriage, long-term commitment here. Hierophant card coming out. And this concern is about lying and deceptions about a breakup. And we see this shock and surprise, this major change here. So you're like, okay, look, you wanna be with me? You're throwing down an ultimatum. Like, you wanna be with me, you love me, you wanna be with me, you're leaving this situation, then you know what? We need to have a long-term relationship. We need something serious here. I'm going to make sure you're not being a player. That Knight of Wands energy is coming out. So there's a sense of seriousness here. And I feel like there's major changes here around this situation. Okay. So I see there's a trying to find a creative solution to work on this, to build something here with the Three of Pentacles energy. Towards a commitment, we see the Wife card coming out. Because of something from before and memories from before, situation from before. And it looks like there's something about a letter, message, document, paperwork. Okay. So you're laying it down like, no. Okay, so let's bring it together so far. What do we got? Okay. Yeah, and this person's saying, I hear them saying they want you back for good. And I see that there was a deceptions. And this person's like, I regret this. And we see that there's this letter, message, document, and happiness about this money and finance situation or about the potential here. Okay, so it's like the moon card showing, okay, moon card. Let's give you guys some clarity about what the moon card is, okay? So the sun's out. You can see everything, right? You see everything, right? Very clearly. The moon's out, you can only see a little bit. Like, I don't know if you guys have ever experienced, but I know I have. When I go on vacation sometimes, and I get there at nighttime, and I'm like, oh my God, the city looks so, the city or the ocean or whatever, looks so beautiful, okay? Then I wake up the next morning, I'm like, okay, this wasn't what I expected it to be. I thought it was a lot nicer at night, but you know how some places they look nicer at night than they do during the day? But anyway, I don't know if you guys experienced this. So it's like rosy colored glasses, okay? So when I see the moon, I'm like, rosy colored glasses going on. Some kind of hidden peril, some kind of deception, something that, some sense of confusion. There's a person that's feeling really sad and upset about the connection with you. And they really want to fix this situation, okay? And they want to bring things into balance with this connection with you. Okay, so now let's see here. Okay, final card is saying, there's a very, I feel like this person's gonna try to buy your affections, okay? Because they were telling the truth. They're gonna try to give you money, try to help you out, all right? Buy your affections. To make some power moves toward you, okay? To try to bring things together. And I see because they're strongly attached to you, they're obsessed with you, and they don't wanna let you go, okay? All right, so because you found out about some stuff and there was lies here, and now this person's like, oh my God, I messed up. I want to fix this. I don't want to lose you. Okay? All right, so let's move this out of the way. You guys see what I'm talking about here. All right. Someone wants to give you what you want. They weren't telling the truth about things from before. You're about to be really happy. There's a sense of wisdom and patience to try to heal this connection. They want to be with you because there's going to be a breakup that's going to happen to bring things together. So they're breaking up with another person to come forward. Now, they could be married. Okay, we see the Hierophant card is involved with this. Okay, there's been this stuck energy, stagnation with somebody from before. We see something about a wife or commitment. There's thoughts and plans. I want to go after what I want. I'm concerned. I'm sad. You know, there's a sense of being used because of this lying and deception. So they're going to try to make some power moves here. Okay, so you get clarity and healing about a third party situation, three of pentacles. And somebody who's walking away, and we see Knight of Wands could talk about player energy, which caused a state of confusion. We see a relationship and a marriage, and we see buying, giving, wanting to bring things into balance. Now, it also could be because of the fact that there was, I could see it another way as well for some of you Pisces. It could also be because of the fact that there could already been marriage, okay? There could have been some lying deception about another situation, okay? And now they know they messed up and they're trying to do what they can to buy your affections, to give to the connection, okay, to fix it. So let's get you guys some advice. But others of you, it looks like they're leaving a marriage to come forward to be with you. Okay, so, and others of you, they're afraid that you're gonna break up with them, okay? So, can I suffice when it comes to my Pisces, when it comes to romance, love life, for their highest, best good, for the best possible outcome for them? Show me the cards I need, please. See? Show me the cards I need. Two. See. My Pisces, let's take a look here. All right. So I feel like it's about learning to meet each other's needs. This is what this card is about. Learning to meet each other's needs. And we see forgiveness. And not letting the same relationship patterns happen. Mm-hmm. Getting to the heart of the matter around this situation. And appreciating this moment. And focusing on being on a high vibrational level, because like attracts like. And being in the present moment and dreaming of the future. And in this case scenario, since this is a very complex situation, you know, asking for some help or some guidance here. And also prayers can help with the situation, okay? All right, so let's move on to your career and finance here, Pisces. Ten of Cups coming out, oh my goodness. Nine of Pentacles, Five of Swords. All right, King of Cups, Strength card, Three of Wands, Four of Swords, Death card, and Page of Swords. So, you are going to be coming into this time period with, oh my goodness, very strong emotional fulfillment and an awareness of that being for the long term. Financial independence, having more than enough money, okay, Nine of Pentacles energy, or focusing on doing your own thing or having financial independence. Now, let's get clarity about this Ten of Cups. Oh my goodness, that's why you're really happy. There's some money coming in here, okay. And it looks like you're getting some advice from somebody because you're concerned about having some kind of defeated energy when it comes to this new beginning, fresh start, okay? It looks like you guys have the key to your success coming in here. When it comes to this advice, there may be some type of criticisms, okay? But definitely there's a recognition of success here with the Moon card energy. So I see here, going further, we got the King of Cups, which shows you guys are trying to make the wisest decision, taking a leadership role, moving towards things that you love. You're looking into things from before, and there's some unknowns for you guys with the Secrets card energy. You guys are feeling very confident, and things are coming into balance for you. But you are concerned about loss, and you're having some temptations, some desires to deal with some of the things from before. I see that there's a lot of offers, opportunities, or something that you've been waiting for coming in. And definitely a lot of people are looking at you like, oh, Pisces, come on over here, come on over there. Okay, there's offers being presented. And so I see that there's these concerns about losing some kind of desire or some kind of temptation. You're like concerned about this loss of temptation because you're like, I don't know, I'm not sure. I have unknown factors. So, because it looks like you have offers coming in, but there's some criticisms about this recognition, this attention, and some unknowns about these desires, which could create some kind of loss. So you are thinking, planning, contemplating. There's something about a meeting or an interview here. And someone wants to resolve something from before. So a business situation from before. Someone's like, you know, let's see if we can give you some more money. Let's see if we can work this out. Okay. But you're still kind of like, I want to end this and I want to go off to something new. And so you're really cautious about this offer. But there is going to be a lot of money presented to you. Okay. So Page of Swords, you're like, I don't know if I'm being naive about this, you know, but you do gain some kind of new perspective, new understanding. And it looks like someone's like, let me help you with this situation when it comes to this movement or change. Okay, so let's talk about it. So you guys got some offers, okay? And there's something about this situation. It looks like some kind of secrets, unknowns, about this business transaction from before, who somebody wants to resolve this because of some kind of criticisms. Now, some of you guys could be dealing with a settlement here because of some issues that happened with this situation from before. I know it's a very specific message, but there were some criticisms, and we see this, this is like the devil card energy. This card right here is like the devil card energy. There could be some overthinking going on, okay? Procrastination, okay? And I see you're getting a lot of money. And you're getting recognition, you're getting recognized, people are noticing you. And also, I see that you're concerned about this loss of recognition, a loss of this situation, and so you're ready to make some changes. So it feels like you're like, let me take advantage of this while I have it and make the changes. But there's a really great offer coming in at the end of the month, it looks like, from the place from before, and they're like, let's just see if we can resolve this with you. Maybe we can give you more money. Okay, so there's a lot of money, and we see some kind of help, advice about a new situation. But someone, the situation from before, is concerned about losing you. And they're like, hey, you know, we really want you. Let's have this meeting. Let's talk about it. There's a cautiousness, and it looks like someone's like, let me help you. Let's do something about this. So it's like they don't want to lose you at this company or this job or this work or this business because they feel like you're a real asset. So it's like you're really happy, you're completely happy with the sense of independence, financial independence, but there's a defeated energy with this King of Cups, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces energy. Now remember, kings are leaders, all right, bosses, leaders. And we see they're wanting to regain your confidence. You have opportunities coming in, something you've been waiting for. And there's a lot of long-term planning towards making this exit here, right? Ending this situation for this new beginning, this fresh start, or because you have new ideas, new understanding, new perspective, Page of Swords energy. Let's see where you go with this. Ah, you're gonna juggle the decision. You're gonna juggle it, so you're not gonna make the decision by the end of the month, okay? It's gonna weigh heavy on you with the Ten of Wands energy. And Star card is very hopeful, optimistic. Yep, we see something about a legal decision. You're at a crossroads. You're not sure what you're gonna do. Okay, let's get you guys some advice. All right, so can I ask my advice for my Pisces? When it comes to their career and finance, for the highest, best, good, the best possible outcome for them, and what they should do now until the end of April, when it comes to their career and finance. Show my cards a C, show my cards a need to C. All right, you know what's good for you guys, okay? You're your own authority here. Surrender and let go. Don't feel bad about this, because I feel like the reason why you don't want to move to the new situation is because you're feeling bad, you're feeling guilty about, you know, I don't want to, you know, burn a bridge here, and I don't want to move past this. Maybe I can juggle both things at once kind of energy. But, you know, you already have the wisdom and know-how of what happened from before, and that's the reason why you want to move on right now, right? So look beyond immediate appearances here. Right? Listen to your heart, your thoughts, all right? Do some planning here. Your obstacles and blockage when it comes to your career and finance are going to be lifted. You have to ask yourself the question, are you going to have a sense of enjoyment? Are you going to be happy in what you're doing? So that's really what you need to focus in on. Are you going to be happy? Are you going to have free time for yourself? Are you going to be overworked? All right? There's a lot of money at stake, yes, but you need to ask yourself the question, all right, we're looking at everything. You guys can put a pros and cons list down, okay? You say, okay, how many hours do I have to do this? What's the pay like? Because sometimes you take on more pay, you get more money, and then there's more expected of you, more responsibility, right? And then, you know, you have to relearn some things. So just really look at this. Really look at this. Is this what you want? And also, obviously, there's a reason why you want to move on to this new situation. It's because you've dealt with some things here in this other situation you're not really happy about. So just weigh the pros and cons here about it. And honor your soul's path, your soul's purpose. Sit back and just listen, okay? You have the foresight of knowing what you want. Choose your priorities, okay? And let go of any judgments around the situation. You know who you are, okay? Listen to the signs and own your power. All right? You don't have to make anything happen. You can just sit back and relax and give yourself some time to think about it. Okay. All right, so Pisces, let's change up camera views here and let's take a look at what you need to know spiritually that you don't know that you need to know can help you. What does Pisces need to know spiritually that they don't know that they need to know that could help them? Now until the end of April, show me cards I need to see. Show me the cards I need to see. As you guys always, I tell you guys, you know, we're only here as guidance. Listen to your heart. Pay attention to your intuition. You guys know what's best for you. You have free will, okay? We're not supposed to infringe upon your free will. Get ready for major changes coming in here, guys. Prayers can help with the situation. Mm-hmm. Saying your obstacles and blockages are going to be lifted. Trust in the universe. Mm-hmm. I know you've been questioning the divine timing. Just listen. It's happening. Focus on following your heart and staying in your heart space. And know you're worthy, okay? So when we start to get into that space of, oh my God, the lack, the scarcity, oh my God, this is gonna happen. Okay, we're putting blockages in our own way. Pull yourself back and put yourself in the heart space, right? Stay in the heart space because that's the only truth. In this world, we have fear, we have love. Always stay in the place of love and you'll stay in flow. All right, my beautiful Pisces, I love you guys so much. If you guys like it this way, you want me to continue this way, hit that like button. Let me know in the comments below. Pisces, you know I want to hear from you guys in the comments below, all right? So if this resonates, you want to claim the message, or you feel comfortable sharing your own personal situation with me, Pisces, I would love to hear from you guys in the comments below. I'll see you guys another day or two. Have a great rest of your next couple days, and I will see you guys soon.